This is Juxbar's tool-assisted speedrun through Quake. Using some clever techniques and superhuman inputs, it beats the human world record by over 2 minutes. It remains the first and only tool-assisted speedrun for the 1996 game. Let's see if we can use computer science to complete the first level faster than this world record. Juxbar's run uses a modified version of Quake called TASQuake. TASQuake adds a user interface with which the user can precisely define inputs in order to complete a level. These inputs are recorded in a script, which can be played back later on. The script itself consists of a series of blocks. Each block has a frame number, defined relative to the previous block, and a series of commands to run on that frame. TASQuake includes algorithms to optimally strafe jump, which are accessible via new commands, the most important of which is TASQuake. To learn more about how this algorithm works, check out my video on strafe jumping in Quake, but for now it suffices to know that this command accelerates the player at the given angle, indicated here by the orange arrow. My plan is to take the existing world record script and tweak the frame numbers and strafe angles to subtly manipulate the player's path and hopefully finish the level faster. The idea is that, much like in motorsport, we'll be able to find an optimal racing line which cuts corners as tightly as possible, maximizes exit speed before long straights, and so on. For reasons that I'll explain later, we'll adjust only inputs towards the end of the first map, E1M1. Our modifications will begin around when this button is pressed, after which the current TAS record jumps down, slides off a grunt's head, navigates round this small corridor, up a ramp, then into the exit. We could do these modifications by hand. However, it'd be more interesting to figure out how to do this search automatically, and it may even be faster. My idea is to use a global optimization algorithm to try a variety of different frame and yaw values to see which give the fastest finish time. The algorithm we will use is called JADE and is a type of differential evolution algorithm. I've previously used this technique to optimize human-like strafe jumping, so watch that video for a bit more of an explanation of how differential evolution works. For now, it is enough to know that this algorithm will attempt to find parameters that minimize an objective function. In our case, the parameters for the objective function are the block frames and the strafe angles, and the objective function's return value is simply the finish time. To implement this function, I use a pared-down version of TASQuake, stripping out all of the graphics and anything superfluous to actually measuring finishing times. This reduced form is compiled down to a library which I can import from a Python script. The interface for this library is pretty simple and includes methods for loading a script, modifying the script with the new frames and yaws, running the script, and extracting the finish time. With this setup, I can run about 200 playthroughs of E1M1 per second, using all cores of a Ryzen 7 5800X. This is about 4,000 times faster than real time. Still, even with these enhancements, it takes a long time to optimize. Here's a visualization of how the population evolves as the optimization progresses. You can see that the paths start far apart and then gradually converge onto the optimal solution. In real time, this took over 70 hours to run and about 50 million simulated games. Here you can see the best time found so far as the optimization progresses. There was a pre-processing step, not shown here, which selects an initial population of 300 runs, all of which finish the level but are otherwise unoptimized for finish time. Even so, at the start, the initial population already beats the unoptimized run by about 0.07 of a second. The fully optimized run improves on this a lot more. Let's see how it does this. The blue player is the unoptimized run, and the yellow is the optimized run. The plot in the corner shows horizontal speed over time. Their paths diverge immediately after the first button press, with some minor deviations until the jump down to the corridor. Instead of sliding off the grunt, the optimized run veers to the right, hitting the bottom of the ramp. The incline converts some of the vertical velocity into horizontal speed, giving a large boost. Soon after, the optimized player collides with a rib that surrounds the corridor, losing some speed, but before landing, somehow manages to accelerate again. From another angle, we can see that the collision is on a sloped area, which pushes the yellow player down a little, increasing downward speed. This lines them up so they hit the lower sloped area of the next rib. The incline of this rib converts some of the vertical speed back into horizontal speed. The yellow player carries this extra speed around the corner before landing as close as possible to the bottom of the final ramp. Landing closer to the ramp means that the next bounce, on the ramp, is at a shallower angle and therefore there is less backwards reaction force. This provides a final speed boost, which is maintained until the finish line. All of these tricks combined save a quarter of a second, which is good considering we only optimized a period of around 5 seconds. If we scale this up to the full game, that would mean a saving of around 30 seconds. Unfortunately, with this method, it's not quite so straightforward. A small change early on in a level is often amplified to a large change later on. This makes it hard for the search algorithm to find routes that make it to the finish line if there are any deviations from the initial route early on. I have some ideas for how to fix this, but I'll leave that for another time. Still, we managed to beat the record on the first map by a decent margin, and, given enough computation time, the same technique could in principle be applied to optimize the end of every level in the game, creating a new Quake TASQ record. As ever, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please click like and consider subscribing if you haven't already. This was a fairly large project, so I omitted a lot of details, so please leave a comment if you have any questions.